My name is Ariana Dixon. I'm a graduate student. The study that I'm working on is part of my master's degree at Boise State University. The first part that I'm looking at is whether or not anticoagulant rodenticides, or a type of rat poison, is a problem for birds of prey. I'm looking into that by using ferruginous hawks as a case study example in Western United States environments. So the first part is just going out, sampling the nestlings, taking blood, getting that sent to a lab to be analyzed for 8 different types of those rodenticides and seeing if it is a problem. So on these banding trips, what we do is we hand capture the nestlings at each nest, and then we put bands on each bird. So each bird gets a unique ID that is managed by one place, and that way when the bird fledges and it flies everywhere, if somebody else finds that bird, whether it's alive or dead, they report it to that place, and we can get population data, we can get movement data, that sort of thing. Ferruginous hawks are really important. They inhabit shrub steppes, they inhabit deserts and grasslands, which we use heavily for our own purposes. It's really important to look at these hawks because if they're not doing so well, it might mean that we're not taking care of the land sustainably, and we want to make sure that we'll be able to use those lands for those purposes for future generations. So this is a good way to monitor how we're doing. Volunteers are incredibly helpful. Even if it's a small thing like recording data, it helps tremendously. It's really hard doing it on your own. Usually one person helps hold the bird and make sure it's calm, and then I take a variety of blood samples. When we have volunteers out there helping, it kind of reduces the stress on the bird. It reduces the time that we have the bird in hand. When it's just me or another person, it takes a lot longer to get everything accomplished. When I do these banding trips, I love bringing people out. It's very rewarding to see their reaction. I think sometimes I take this stuff for granted. You know, I go out, I need, you know, X amount of samples for my research, and, you know, some of it can be monotonous, and that's why, one of the reasons why I love these banding trips is just taking people out, getting them close to the natural world, seeing what they have in their backyards is pretty incredible, and just their astonishment at what we're doing just fulfills me even more. And I love to share what we're doing. I think it's really important. And just to have these spectacular creatures in hand is just an amazing experience. And I just want to share that with everybody. So these banding trips are a great avenue for that.